Huh?
Yes.
All right.
Empezamos con el trimantra. ¿Quién quiere cantar?
This is my brother Manu. Bueno.
Oh, hi, Jay
Oh,
Sachidanan.
Jay Sachidanan.
Manu.
Jay Sachidanan, glad to
Manu,
have Sachidanan here
yeah.
at our place, carrying a ball here.
Manu has now built, he has moved to Tampa, and so I'm there in his home right now. We've been enjoying his home and his hospitality and his company, you know.
Es good
Este es el hermano de Sudan Manu y vive en Tampa, así que está disfrutando de su hospitalidad, ¿no? Y de este tiempo. Ahora Sudan está en Tampa. Bueno. Thanks, Manu.
¿Quién
So,
canta el trimantra?
three mantra.
Manu.
Yes.
The last time we were in page 86, and the last title was "The Lord Saw Only One Pudgal."
Yes, right. Wonderful. So, Carlos and Sandra.
Cantamos con Carlos, Patri.
Sí, obvio. Yo no
Okay.
los acompaño.
Dale, dale. Namo Vidragai, Namo Arihantana, Namo 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 Namo
Jai Sachidanand, so wonderful. Both Sandra and Carlos, so wonderful. Thank you so much. Now, in the far corners of the world, you see, very far away from the world, you have Mahatmas who are continuing to become more and more exact in the science of Akram Vignan. And not only that, they are also effective, very effective early Mahatmas who gently, through their own fragrance, natural fragrance, are sharing this science with human beings around them. This is a phenomenal process, you see. This is an absolutely phenomenal process.
Dice que muy lejos en el mundo hay mahatmas que continúan volviéndose cada vez más exactos y efectivos en esta ciencia, y que de forma muy natural comparten su natural fragancia en este proceso para todos, para enseñar, ¿no?
Yes, this natural fragrance increases in its intensity and it's directly proportional to the natural dissolution of any discharging ego in the light of the self. So the more the light of the self, the more the light of the self, the more there is ego-less interaction, you see.
Cuanto mayor es esta natural fragancia de la ciencia, cuanto más va creciendo, su intensidad es directamente, está directamente relacionada con la descarga del ego. Entonces, cuanto más, se descarga el ego, mayor es la luz del ser.
So Shuddhatma Bhagavan, you know, that is how this magnificent process is happening as we, the blissful ones of Dada, begin to see this phenomenon of Mahatmas in this relative world in association with our own Jagruti, awakened awareness.
Nosotros podemos ver a los dichosos y sí, a los dichosos, ¿no? Que somos dichosos de poder ver este fenómeno en los Mahatmas, cómo todo esto verá, ver este proceso cómo va creciendo.
Yes, all right. So, don't mind this little bit of swelling here. This is, you know, when Nima and I were picking up a lot of mangoes for this Mahatmas, for the Shibir, you know, and the mango acidic drops touch me, and there is this skin reaction. I'm fine. Like, give me 1 minute and I'll be right back, okay? I just need to get something, okay?
Dice Suda que estaba juntando unos mangos para traerle los Mahatmas, y que uno de ellos tenía una semillita que le cayó en la piel, por eso tiene el ojo así, es una reacción de la piel. Ahora se va 1 minuto y vuelve.
All right, I'm back. I'm sorry about that. Okay, so I've shared with you the link for the last satsang in details. In fact, we are, the way it is going in our satsang, we are very close to the mountaintop of Akram Vignan in our series of satsangs that are happening, you see.
Estamos llegando al tope de la montaña con esta serie de satsang que hemos estado viendo.
Yes, you see, now today this we begin and continue with the 76th session, and I will give you the next heading here. The next heading on page 86, Gujarati. Is there is no difference in the matter of seeing, you see?
El título es no hay diferencia en la en materia en el tema de ver con mayúsculas.
Yeah, and now the seeing is with S capital, you see? So in other words, Jova, Jovu. So no difference. Jovu means to see. You see, Jovu. And Janavu means to know. All right. So these are the two very important terms in our Akram. Separation, Vignan. Separation through ourself. Separation that is natural. The moment you say Soyamapura, you and I say Soyamapura, the separation is there. And then in that separated, in that state, where you and I have come home, the seeing changes. The seeing changes. There is a new seeing through the eyes of the self. This is antar chakshu, divya chakshu, divine vision. You see?
Yes. Bueno, el título es este, no hay diferencia en el tema de ver con mayúscula, y da dos palabras, una que es yo-hu, que es ver con mayúsculas, y yana-vu, que es saber también con mayúscula. Es la separación del ser, esta separación natural del ser. Cuando decimos soy alma pura, estamos en este estado, ¿no? Y los mismos cambios nos llevan a la visión divina.
So the questioner essentially begins by saying, Dada, such awareness, such jagruti state, such state of awareness, which would happen to everyone. No, in everyone means every Mahatma.
Le preguntan a Dada, ¿este tal estado de conciencia sucederá a todos todos los Mahatmas?
Yeah, in other words, would it a such state of awareness where we have gone so much further since the awakening in the Gnanvidhi many years ago that now we begin to see more and more through the natural view, of the self, you see.
Este estado de conciencia que ya venimos bien, ya han pasado varios años desde que comenzamos, vamos adquiriendo esta este estado de visión natural y divino.
So the questioner asks another question. In other words, those who are going towards keval gnan, keval means only, or absolute. Those who are proceeding towards keval gnan, keval, only knowledge, only, exclusively knowledge only and nothing else. Those who are proceeding towards keval gnan, the such awareness and the such state of awareness, this awareness would come for all of them, right?
En ese estado de conciencia llegaría a todos los mahatmas, este estado de keval, que quiere decir absoluto. Todos los mahatmas vamos a alcanzar ese estado, le preguntan a Dada.
Yeah, so the questioner asks two questions, you see. Dada Shri replies that everyone has to go on this line only. You see, there is no other line.
Y Dada Shri responde, dice, todos tienen que ir en esta línea. No hay otra manera.
Yeah.
Es el único camino.
The line is only one, right? No, line is only one.
Only la línea, one. El camino es solo uno. Solo
yeah.
Uno.
You see? Whether it is akram or kramik. Akram or kramik is the same line.
Akram y kramiko es la misma línea.
It's the same line. In other words, both the target, the end point of akram or kramik is to be liberated, to come home, to be who you are, comma, continuously, to be who you are continuously.
El camino krámico y el akrámico son caminos que la intención es llegar a la liberación. Entonces, esa es la intención.
See, the method is different. The kramik goes step by step by step. I will never tell a lie. I have done something bad. I'll have to now do a lot of pratikraman, etc., etc. It is in akram. It's the five agnas. Akram is five agnas directly. So the method is different, but the line means the subtle, that which accomplishes your goal of liberation. Line means that which is accomplishing your goal of liberation is the same. You see?
Si bien los es alcanzar esta la meta de la liberación es la misma el camino del crámico o de la o crámico o del acram el método es diferente porque en el camino crámico es paso a paso y el acram es este inmediatamente somos elevados pero lo que queremos la liberación que queremos alcanzar es la línea en común.
And then the questioner is asking, only when such a thing happens, then he goes to moksha.
Entonces, solo cuando esto sucede, vas a moksha.
So Dadashri says, only then, only after that, only after that.
Solo después de eso, dice Dada.
He solo goes después. To moksha, you see. Goes to...
No hay ego. Ningún ego va a moksha.
Moksha means... This moksha is such. This moksha means no further entry, no further entry into this, into a body of any kind, any physical body. You see, no returning into a body of any kind, no future bodies, you see.
Moksha quiere decir aquí este no entrar, no volver a entrar en un cuerpo físico. No volver a entrar.
No entry, right? So he says Dadashri says whether he is a Kevali or a Tirthankar. And we have I think shared with you the difference between a Kevali and a Tirthankar, no? In the last time?
Yes. Yes, you said that the Tirthankar comes back to liberate millions of souls, and the Kevali is not to come back.
Yeah, so the line... whether the line is the same, what line? So whether he is a Tirthankar or he a Kevali. Kevali means the one now who has absolute
knowledge,
absolute knowledge. The line is the same. What line is it? Then the answer is the line of seeing. You see.
Tanto el titán, lo que vale y Tirthankar tienen la misma línea, que es volverte el absoluto conocedor.
I'm sorry. We did, I think we covered this. Now, actually, we are on page 87. I just gave you because the next one was Lord Mahavir saw only one Pudgala. We covered
yes,
that.
Yes.
So now the next heading. Okay, so it doesn't matter. We repeated this. All right, let's go now on page 87, Gujarati. Badhi kriya juve koma jane. This is the heading. Next heading is badhi kriya. So one sees all kriya now. All kriya. Kriya means activity of mind, speech, body is seen and known. Now that's the heading. Badhi kriya ne juve jane. That's all. See all activities of mind, speech, and body.
Entonces el título es ver todas las actividades de la mente, el cuerpo y el habla.
Es kriya means action or activity, right? Activity.
Kriya es acción o actividad.
Right, So there is only two things in this universe. One is it's all somebody's doing this, somebody's doing that, somebody's doing this. This dog is running from there, from here to there. The man is kicking the ball from here to there. The woman is doing whatever she is doing in the kitchen or in the home. So you see, so there is only the activity of, there is only Kriya. There is Kriya going on, you know, wherever, everywhere there is Kriya. Kriya happens through mind, speech, and body, right? So all of this Kriya is going on. And then there is the I in all of them, the eternal one, the knower, you see. So there is a knower and there is a Kriya. Once the knower moves away, once the mover moves away, then the Kriya stops, you see. Kriya stops. That is when the knower leaves the body, what we call that process death. This one was active and now there is no activity, and so he's cold, his body is cold, and he's dead, you see. This one is dead. The Kriya and the activity, again the entry into the next body, and again there is Kriya. The little baby is, you know, moving, smiling, etc.
Kriya es la actividad de la mente, del cuerpo y el habla, y después está el conocedor. Entonces solo el conocedor solo conoce y ve lo que sucede, las actividades de la mente, del cuerpo, del habla, Kriya. Entonces cuando el conocedor se retira es porque el cuerpo se murió. Y se lleva consigo todo para continuar con el proceso de un nuevo cuerpo, una nueva vida.
So the now the it's just a five line five sentences of Dada here, no questions. Dada Sri begins by saying it, you feel as if this person is doing all this activity, you know, Gavi feels that Shuddha is doing all of these things, talking, saying, or Patri is doing all of this, speaking, etc. Gavi, it just feels to Gavi that Shuddha or Patricia or Sandra is doing whatever she is doing in this YouTube, you see. You feel as if they're doing activity, Kriya, like, you know, they're doing activities, you know, you're moving your hand from here to here, all of these things, you see, activity of the mind, speech, and body. Gabi simply feels as if we are doing this, or we are doing all of this, right?
Por ejemplo, Gaby siente que Shuddha está hablando, que Patricia está diciendo estas palabras, que están haciendo estas cosas. Pero esto es lo que Gaby siente, y esto es Kriya.
Kriya. Kriya. Kriya is, I think at the original level, is connected with the word karavu, to do something. You say karavu, Kriya.
Karuku originalmente es hacer algo.
They're doing it, you see. But
and in Spanish is to raise a children. If you pronounce criar in Spanish is to raise a
to bring up children.
Baby, kid. Yes.
I see. Whereas, you know, you just realize that Dada is now speaking about himself. Here, just imagine Dada sitting in front of us. See? And Dada is saying, you all feel that this one in front of us, Dada, M. Patel, is doing everything, right? You know?
Dada está sentado con toda la gente frente de él y les dice, ¿ustedes creen que este M. Patel es el que está haciendo esto?
Lord of these activities. But Dada says, you know, you may feel, because I'm sitting here in front of all of you looking at me, looking at this one, all of you looking at this A.M. Patel, you may feel he's doing this, he's doing that, he's talking, he's moving his arms, hands, etc. You may feel that he's doing this. But in all of this activity that this one is doing, Ambalal is doing, you see, oh, we are not the doer of it at all. We are not the doer of it at all.
Tú puedes sentir, decía Dada, continúa diciendo, que estás mirando lo que en Balal Patel, que él está haciendo esto, que habla, que mira, que está sentado. Y en esta actividad de en Patel, yo no soy, no somos los hacedores.
Yeah,
no soy el hacedor.
We continue. So whatever A.M. Patel is doing, we continue to see. We continue to see all that, you see.
En A.M. Patel dice que continúa viendo todo lo que sucede.
You know, Dada is now my friends. Dada is describing exactly what is happening there, right there inside. Dada is actually speaking about the science in operation, the science in operation, you see?
Yes. Dada está describiendo lo que sucede y en realidad está explicando la ciencia en operación, cómo opera la ciencia.
We see that he is brushing his teeth.
Podemos ver que él cepilla sus dientes.
You know, in those days of Dada, there were this particular, this is just for your interest, in those days of Dada, before the advent of the toothpaste and toothbrush, not commonly available, you know, they used to have this green, very flexible branches and stick out of it of a tree that is a neem tree, you see, like a special tree which has got medicinal properties, and they'll take about this much length of that green tree branch stick, you see. So when you chew it, it becomes soft and soft and soft, so you just keep on chewing it, chewing it, chewing it. One end becomes like a brush, and it's got fibers in it, all of that. When the juice comes out, it is very beneficial to your mouth and teeth. It feels good, and then once the brush has formed with your teeth, it also gives massage to your teeth, you see, and the gums. So, and then you use that end to brush your all your teeth, you see. So it's called Dathan, you see. It's Dath means teeth, and Dathan means that means an instrument, you see. Instrument to brush the teeth.
Yes. Dice que cuando Dada cepillaba sus dientes, bueno, en esos días no había cepillo y pasta, él usaba unas ramas flexibles de un árbol que tenían propiedades medicinales, ¿no? Entonces se lo ponía en la boca y lo masticaba, y se iba volviendo cada vez más suave, y también iba absorbiendo los jugos que largaba esta rama, que es bueno, y es bueno, como que tiene un buen aroma, y además es un masaje para los dientes, ¿no? Y después con esa misma rama se cepillaba los dientes. Entonces, de acá viene la palabra that, tan, que that es diente y tan es instrumento, ¿no?
I've tried. When Shuddha was a young medical, young student, went to India to study medicine, you know, in the villages I have tried this, you see, and, you know, and it's interesting. Supposing you have taken a 10-inch piece of this twig, then you've done this brushing, etc. Now, you know, you can cut it, you know, they throw it away, and now you got an 8-inch for the next time you want to brush. So it's the handle is always there, you know, and when you go to the vegetable markets, you know, the vegetable markets, they sell this, they are green, freshly cut green twigs, you know.
Oh, este dice que estudiantes de medicina lo han probado y hay este entonces lo probaron, ¿no? Y por ejemplo tenés una vara de este tamaño de 10 pulgadas, ponele, y entonces lo usás y cuando terminaste de usar le cortás esa parte que usaste y te va quedando un poquito menos. Este, y esto tiene, esto lo puedes conseguir en los mercados de vegetales.
Yes, so Dada Shri says, now, you know, while he's doing, you know, while he's brushing his teeth, or if he's running around, he appears like there is no time left, etc. So he's so busy doing this and that, we continue to see that too. You see.
Mientras que Dada se cepilla los dientes o hace cosas, parece como que está muy ocupado, pero nosotros estamos observando.
You see, whether it's, you know, there is this term, you're so busy. Like some people, you know, when you go, when you see them, they're constantly moving from one end of the home to the other, you know, one room to the other, you know, doing this, doing that, everything, you see. There is nothing to be done. What they'll do is they'll open up the cupboard and they will empty everything, take a piece of cloth and clean everything and then put it back again, you see.
Hay gente que está todo el tiempo en movimiento, ¿no? Este, que va yendo y viniendo todo el día y cuando termina de hacer lo que tiene que hacer, va a los estantes, saca los libros, los limpia y después los vuelve a poner y así en actividad todo el tiempo. O being lazy. O siendo...
So there's another person in the home who just sits and sits. Oh, he'll say... There usually is the lady of the home. There she goes again. You know, there she goes again. Now there are enough pots with flowers in around, but you know, wants to go buy some more seeds and plant some more and, you know, flowers. But who's going to take care of all of this when you're not at home, you see?
Y por ejemplo, el marido está sentado en el sillón y ve a la mujer que va y viene y que limpia, que esto, que lo otro, y después este. Tienen montones de macetas con flores, este, pero ella va y compra más plantas y las planta y él dice, bueno, ¿quién va a cuidar todo esto cuando vos no estés?
So now Dada says, we continue to see that. You see, now he continued to see that. At the same time, Dada says, we know that there is a timeline. At this particular location, there was a rush of activities, you know. Oh, get out of my way. I need to do this. I need to do that. You see, so you just are so involved that you just push away the other person, etc. You know, you know, you run from one room to the other to try to find your keys. Where is your purse? Where is this, that, etc. So that's called being super busy. Yes, so busy that super busy in doing, you see.
Por ejemplo, estás en un estado en el que tienes que salir, entonces vas buscando las cosas, las llaves, la billetera, te vas a la otra habitación, le pedís a la gente que se corra, que te deje pasar, y eso es una actividad de estar muy ocupado, súper ocupado.
Yeah, so you see, Dada Shri says, so we continue to see that all. A.M. Patel is kind of rushed up right now, you know, he needs to do things in a hurry, etc. And at other times, A.M. Patel is just sitting there, you know, like this on the chair, just watching everything. He's saying he's being lazy. Huh? We see that. We see, but so, no, we continue to see that, and we also know that at this particular time, at a certain time, he became super busy, very deeply involved in the activity, you see, that he was doing, super busy. It is a specific term. That's super busy is being, super busy in activity is the opposite of laziness, sitting and not doing anything, right?
Yes. Dada dice que continúes viendo y conociendo, ¿no? En Patel tenía como que tenía muchas, había muchas actividades donde él estaba haciendo cosas, ¿no? Y era como, estaba muy, muy ocupado. Pero él dice, continúa viendo, observando y, y siendo el conocedor de esta actividad que está sucediendo. Y lo contrario de tener una actividad súper, ser activo, súper activo, es ser como vago, vagoneta, así de estar tirado.
Super, super busy. Some people are super busy, but they do everything in correctness. They just go, one, two, three, four, five. They do, but they're very active, but they do it correctly, whatever needs to be done. And there are others who when they have to do this thing, when they enter into it, their mind gets upset a little bit. Oh, no, you just go out. For instance, Nima will tell me, don't come here in the kitchen at all. Stay away. Don't come out. Don't come here. I'm busy. You see, so at that time, I have to stay out of the kitchen, you see. But you see, the activity goes on. So there is this super activity that is associated with a state that where you do not want to be disturbed. You think, okay, you're in full control of doing whatever you're doing. You want to do. You become a super doer.
Yes. Estas personas, por ejemplo, que están súper ocupadas, quieren hacer las cosas de manera correcta, ¿no? Entonces, los ves así en actividad que van y que vienen y su mente por ahí se altera un poco, y por ahí quieren entrar a la cocina y no nos dejan entrar a la cocina, y es un estado, en que no, I don't remember the last words.
It's a super doer activity. What happens is, the super doer will, in other words, he is so actively doing everything that he doesn't want to get disturbed in what he's doing.
Oh, yes, yes. Perdón, perdón, yes. Bueno, y están tan ocupados en lo que están haciendo, están tan involucrados en lo que están haciendo que no quieren ser molestados de ninguna manera.
Yeah, so, Sandra is doing something. She will say, Carlos, don't come here. Don't leave me alone. I'm doing my thing. You see,
Por ejemplo, Sandra está haciendo algo y Carlos está por entrar y le dice, no, no entres, que estoy haciendo esto. Y ella continúa haciendo lo que está haciendo.
And so the most important thing is Dada, Nani Purush Dada Shri, is saying what M. Patel has been doing, whatever he is doing, but only also knows that in this particular time, also knows when M. Patel was a little, became a super doer or became, super doer where he didn't want to get disturbed by others, you see. He got too involved in it. Super doers usually are super involved,
Dada podía ver que en Patel era estaba muy ocupado, ¿no? Que era un super hacedor, y que estaba muy involucrado con lo que estaba haciendo.
So, so you know, this is not part. This is the end of this little heading, which is, you know, Dada begins by saying, "You may, as you look at me, you may think that I'm doing all of these things. You see, but
decía,
I'm not at all usted, connected." Yeah, sorry, go on. Mm-hmm.
Dada decía, ustedes pueden sentir o creer que yo estoy haciendo esto.
Yeah, so you see, one thing and knowing. So if you look at, if you understand what I've just shared with you, if you kind of look at it here, the seeing, Dada says, but I continue to see what A.M. Patel is doing. Continue to see what A.M. Patel is doing. No interruption. Continue to see what he is doing. You see? Now, go on.
Dice Dada, dice, yo estoy en el continuo observar de lo que A.M. Patel está haciendo.
Yeah, we continue. And, you know, because this is a continuous process. If you start to see what Christian is doing, you know, the seeing.
Este es un proceso continuo, ¿no? De estar observando qué es lo que Christian está haciendo.
Yeah, Christian is seeing. You continue to see what Christian is doing. You see, you are the awakened one inside. You are the one, you're the Amapura one who says, Ishbin, I mean, so Amapura, so Amapura. You continue to see what Christian is doing, you see. So, and now, but then he says, so the seeing is continuous. And also, we know, and associated with seeing, there is that knowledge where Christian became a little bit exclusively upset because he got so involved in doing whatever he was doing, you see. So there is the lazy part, there is the slow part, easy part, and then there is a super doer part, you see.
Todo el tiempo estar viendo, observando qué es lo que Cristian hace, ¿no? Podemos ver cuando está en un estado así de relax profundo, que no hace nada, si está súper ocupado, si está molesto. Entonces conocemos todas esas partes de Cristian.
Sí. You and I, this thing. And knowing, seeing, knowing, seeing, knowing, see, no, see, no. The seeing, knowing is being split artificially, and split, I wouldn't say artificially, is being split in when you have to write it and kind of explain the fine point of this vision at the peak of the mountain. You're almost at the peak of the mountain now. You know, we have climbed up from the foothills of the mountain, going around and around, seeing our own faults, doing, you know, pratikramans, you know, applying the agnas, etc., etc. Now, Dada, in this 75th, 76th session, has brought us here at this level where we are, you know, we're approaching the seeing, knowing part, you see.
En esto de ver y conocer y poder poder entenderlo, poder sacarlo y verlo, es ¿cómo lo podemos explicar? Y es como estamos en la montaña subiendo y vamos subiendo a la montaña. Y Dada nos trajo a la parte más alta con este conocimiento.
This seeing and knowing is happening simultaneously. Dada has given a very beautiful example. I continue to see A.M. Patel, whatever he's doing, but I also know where he was upset. You know, so the super, when you become super doer exclusively, let me do it. No, leave it alone. You don't know how to do it. You know, this is not how we do it. Let me, you know, so now, you know, so that is called super doer. offense in a way, you know. In other words, now you got so deeply involved in doing whatever you're doing, you see.
Este cuando en esta actividad uno se transforma en el superhacedor, y no quiere que lo molesten de alguna manera, hay un punto donde ofende.
You see, super duper people, you and I know, they will say, as soon as they come in, they say, all of you out of the room, come on, let me handle it. You see?
Están las personas en una habitación y haciendo cosas, y él dice, no, no, déjenme manejarlo a mí.
I don't want any noise, all of you remain quiet, let me handle it, I know what to do it, right? You know, now, how can such a person... really know about evidences.
Y esta persona que es una super hacedora y está haciendo, dice, por favor, todos en silencio, no me molesten, yo voy a hacerme cargo de esto, lo voy a hacer.
Yeah,
no me molesten.
While he's doing, if something happens to his hand, he cannot move it properly, you see. By the way, the initial sign, yeah, I'll come to Christian in a minute. In the initial sign of weakness of your hand or your arm is that when you try to hold something, it will shake, you see. You know, it will shake. There's some weakness, you see. You know, you can't, you know, the strength is gone. So it's people who are developing very early cerebral insufficiency, not enough blood coming to the other side, you know, this side of the brain, the hand will shake a little bit, you know, or it won't be steady, you see, won't be steady.
Por ejemplo, si vemos en el file que quiere agarrar algo y que pierde y como que no tiene fuerza para agarrarlo, es como que perdió esta fuerza para agarrar, ¿no? Y esto puede ser que tiene una insuficiencia de sangre en la cabeza o en el cuello del otro lado. Entonces, al no tener fuerza suficiente, la mano va a temblar.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Christian. Yes, Chetan.
Yes, Chetan. Yes, Shuddha. My question is... when you're talking about being super doer, and at some point, I've seen Christian when he comes to be a super doer or start to do lots of things in the day, he gets absorbed by the day, and it happens just what you have described. You start to at least at the best day, not telling no one nothing, but internal opinions go on and on and on. So my question is, I try to maintain separation, because what I feel it's the complicated thing is that Christian, the Chandu of Christian, the Putgal, has to do a lot of things to get paid every month. So, and try to observe what he's doing, although he's doing a lot of things. So what would be like the recipe to stay in the five agnas all that time?
Traducirlo, por favor. Divino.
Que Cristian tiene obviamente que hacer muchas cosas para recibir su plata, su sueldo a fin de mes. Por lo tanto, hay muchas cosas en las que está haciendo en el día a día. Y aunque ha mejorado su estándar en no retar a la gente, o no enojarse hacia afuera, sí dentro genera una serie de opiniones cuando las cosas están ocurriendo en el día a día y no están ocurriendo como él cree. Entonces, o que debiesen ocurrir. Entonces le estaba pidiendo alguna forma de receta o alguna forma para mantener la separación mientras Cristian observa al Putgal en el día haciendo todo lo que tiene que hacer o que por karma le tocó hacer.
Yes, it's a very good question. You know, and the The answer is in the seeing. In the seeing, you know, the other. So there is, the other begins by saying, I see what M. Patel is doing. See, it, I see, I can, and but also he adds a lot, a second word, I see continuously. Now, if you and I are seeing, you know, if you're seeing what Christian is doing, then you're already, that is exactly who you are. You are the seer of what Christian is doing. Now, the superdoer activity is actually programmed. Now, when you understand that the superdoer activity is programmed, so some people are, you know, they, at the moment they come in, they do everything, and rather so just say, take it easy and see what's happening, you see, and only kind of put the car in gear when they have to do something themselves, you see, like, you know, put the car in gear. Otherwise, they are just cruising along in neutral gear all day long. Neutral gear all day long, you see. Now, you see, so what can you do? The answer is, there is no doer, nothing that you can do for this. It is part of the nature of the prakritis. Okay, the prakritis are already formed this ways. You see, now the word ragvat, in the very word, the way the Gujarati word sounds, ragvat. You see, is in other words, you know, it's just, it sounds almost like, you know, you are nicely enjoying your morning cup of tea, and you know the birds are singing, and all of a sudden the, you know, the lady in the home turns on this big, you know, machine cooking, you know, slicing, you know, grinding machine, which makes so much noise. Oh, you know. Right? You know, and you say, what? Where did that come from? You see? So in the same way, human beings, when they get super active, they make noises, you see. They think they are doing their work, but they're not aware that. Now, I'm not saying that that's happening to you because you're getting your work accomplished. But if you feel, hey, but at the same time, see those lazy guys, they're not doing anything. They never help. What does he do? This is a mistake here. He doesn't. He's always making mistakes. While you're doing your work, you're looking at all of these things. I'm not done. Now that's an error. That's a problem. Now you have slipped. You have become the, you know, the engrossed superdoer, and the... There's a very fine distinction between seeing the superdoer and kind of feeling and slowly becoming part of the superdoer, you know, again saying, you know, I hate these people. They don't do their work properly, you know. It is associated with a very subtle presence of pride, Kashai, you see. Pride, you know, I can do it. And others don't know how to do it. I'm the doer. I do it better, I say. So again, it comes out, you're right, again comes back to the Agna understanding. See, if you can do fast work, if you can accomplish and bring out a lot of good products at the end of the day without disturbing anyone, there is no problem at all. You continue to see the Christian is able to do that. What Dada is teaching us is, some of us are very good in our work, whatever we do. Dada is taking us away from the sense of the pride of doership. I did it. Because you say, because you feel you can do better than the other person, automatically you have jumped into the kashai of pride. You see, whereas you can say, oh no, Christian has come with these abilities, you know, he's good at this. You have to say, you tell Christian, do it here, yeah, you're doing great, you know. But don't find fault with the other human being, you see, you know. So that is the approach. Sorry, I've spoken so long. Now you go ahead and tell others how, you know, in your language.
Bonjour, Christian. Dice que a la respuesta de Cristian, ¿no? Que el superhacedor, la actividad del superhacedor está programado. Entonces, otros tienen otros prakrutis tienen otra programación y son más tranquilos o hacen otras cosas. Pero en definitiva, Dada dice, no hay hacedor. El prakruti viene formado así, ¿no? Y por ejemplo, hay una palabra en Gujarati que es dragwati, que es por ejemplo, estás desayunando, estás tomando un café tranquilo, los pájaros cantan, el día es hermoso y de repente la esposa se pone a cocinar y usa las máquinas de la cocina y hace un montón de ruido y le rompe la paz al marido, ¿no? Pero, y él empieza como a criticar, pero ahí en la crítica es como que vas salís del alma pura, ¿no? Y te convertís en el file. Y esto tiene que ver con cuando criticamos o que yo lo puedo hacer mejor, tiene que ver con el kashai de el orgullo. Y entonces es volver a las agnas. Si vos podés hacer tu trabajo de una buena forma y lo podés hacer más rápido, está perfecto, hacelo, pero sin generar problemas para los demás ni críticas. No, porque en realidad no eres el hacedor y que no mires a ninguna persona en falta. There is a sentence you said the last time that it was beautiful. I was reading it yesterday again and it's we do not have to enter in the things that how it have to be. No, just look what is happening.
To see, this is exactly what Dada is again repeating in today's satsang. See, he is saying it in Niruma has brought it together again. I've given a more precise heading, which is Budhikriya Juve Jane. So this is this. Dada is talking about his example, his own personal, what is happening. He wants us to begin in that direction now, you see. He wants us to begin in this direction. First of all, this separation has already been accomplished, and this Christian is exactly separate, is separate. But he is his activities are being seen. His activities are being seen. All activities. This is not the visible, only the visible activities. There are the invisible activities also going on, which Christian described, which is saying when he said, opinions come in. You see, about other people while this is going on. Opinions is kashai, you see. There is opinion means you have mixed with the discharging ego, you see. Opinions cannot happen if you are the knower of the discharging ego. You see, if you see that the owner of this one, well, even when he is doing all of this super duty, super work, you know, there is this other stuff that is flying out, which is he's upset. He is seeing faults of others. The only way to become upset is when you see faults of others. When you continue to see, simply see, then there is no time to become upset. There is not even a split second left for you to become upset, because the one who becomes upset is seeing faults. Whereas you are seeing what is happening. Christian is upset. Christian is seeing faults of others. So this, you know. So in further answer to what Christian just brought up is, further answer, continue to see what kind of opinions Christian is having. You are not supposed to do anything about it. Continue to see. He's having this opinion. He's having this opinion. He's frustrated about. He's frustrated about this. He wants to complain about this. All of this continue to see here, you know, in the seeing there is a lot of resolution. In the seeing there is a beautiful process that is happening. The seeing leads you to know with a K, capital know. What is this? What's all this? He continues to know. There is no fatigue. And there is no, you don't get tired, you don't get bored. You know? You just see how the Prakriti is unfolding.
Yes. Thank you. Entonces dice que le está contando lo que le pasa a M. Patel, ¿no? Y es en esa dirección que se dirige cuando en esto. Entonces la separación ya sucedió y lo que Cristian puede ver son las actividades de Cristian, las visibles y las invisibles continúan por dentro. Por ejemplo, las opiniones. Las opiniones están relacionadas con los kashais. Estas opiniones surgen cuando te mezclas con el ego de descarga. Entonces, por ejemplo, Cristian está molesto y la molestia sucede cuando vemos faltas en los otros. Pero si nosotros vemos, estamos en el estado de ver con mayúsculas, no hay tiempo para molestarse. Porque cuando estamos molestos lo que vemos son faltas, pero si estamos en el estado del observador absoluto, no hay tiempo para ver faltas. Las opiniones de Cristian de que quiere quejarse y todo eso también son kashais, ¿no? Entonces, Dada dice que ver el hermoso proceso que sucede y conocer qué es lo que está sucediendo nos lleva a un estado de no fatiga y no hay aburrimiento ahí, porque todo el tiempo estamos viendo y conociendo lo que sucede.
Yeah, I see, this raghavat, super busy activity is not the problem. Super busy activity, the lack of seeing, you know, S capital seeing is the problem. You see, in other words, if you can see that this is, you know, Christian is generally very relaxed, you know, except when he is actively involved in the doing the activities, that sense that I am doing it, the niyabla coming in, the fog coming in is the problem, you know. And that's why one of the greatest, you and I spend 10 sessions talking about niyabla, it is not enough, you see. And again, when you are with the Gnani, the most important thing to explore with the Gnani is this niyabla business, you know, the sense that this is happening to me. Lada Shri begins this satsang this morning by saying, it feels as if it seems to you, here is M. Patel. It seems to you M. Patel is doing this, he's doing that, he's doing this, he's talking, he's doing it. Or you can see him, he's doing it. But I'm not at all in all of that activity of M. Patel. I mean, this is absolutely magnificent. I am not at all in any of those doership. I'm not in that doership. Is the doership belongs to this M. Patel. M. Patel will do whatever he is gonna do. I continue to see that. 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 You see, in other words, his seeing is undisturbed. Whereas our seeing is, we are rising to that level of seeing by understanding this, you know, live Dada in front of you and what's happening in him. What is happening in him?
Yes. El estar súper ocupado, la actividad de estar súper ocupado no es el problema. No ver la actividad, ese es el problema, ¿no? Porque si no estamos en el sentido del hacedor o de que esto me pasa a mí, me sucede a mí. Ya estamos en el estado de niebla, ¿no? De ilusión. Y Dada dice, Mahen Patel es el hacedor. ¿Ustedes creen que esto lo estoy haciendo yo? Yo de hablar, de tomar un té o moverme. No, no, es Mahen Patel el hacedor. Yo estoy en continuo estado de ver. Y en este estado no hay molestias y lo que surge es el entendimiento. Y es este entendimiento de qué le sucede en Patel, pero yo estoy en estado de ver continuamente.
You know, my friends, we'll return to this. This is, we're just touching this magnificent gold that we have found at this level. You know, we're just appreciating the beauty of it, you see. And we'll go further in it. Let's take a break, huh? Yeah. And we come back then again, all right? Yeah? All right.
Okay. Tocar esto es como tocar oro en polvo. Y vamos a un recreo. Thank you, Shuda. Thank you. Vamos a 18.
Estoy en casa, Sansa. Si quieres pasar a buscar el papel, subí que tenés la llave.
So,
sí. ¿Me escuchas? ¿Qué quieres decirle? Sí, te escucho. Acércate un poquito más al micrófono, porque te siento lejos.
Ok. Sandra está muy feliz de que Dada lo haya puesto en nuestras vidas hace 8 años para acompañar este bendito camino. Quería agradecer su amorosidad y dedicación.
¿Qué quieres decir, ayuda? Que le dedicas tu, le agradeces su amor y dedicación, que es nuestro cumpleaños hoy. No te...
Y hace 8 años que nos viene acompañando.
Dale. Ayuda, Sandra, and I think all of us, we want to say thank you to you. We are very grateful because you, today is our non-Vidi birthday. And say thank you for you that you come along with us all this time, giving such love and kindness and this knowledge.
You know, this, thank you. You know, this expression, this what you have just conveyed, Sandra, and all of you, is will continue forever for all the Mahatmas, you see. This appreciation that arises is really an appreciation for the beauty of Dada. You know, you appreciate, you know, you love Dada so much that anyone who comes and gives you anything that is related to Dada, that is received with phenomenal gratitude, you see. So that's how it is. Years down the line, many, many years and many generations, this is the way. This is the way it is, and I don't want those. You know, I receive this and I say, oh, Dada, this is magnificent. In other words, I am with, you are with me. I'm not sharing anything that does not belong, that is not yours, you see. Dada, this is just you. Look, these are your Mahatmas, Dada, that are here, you know, and so it is very beautiful. Thank you. Yes, I appreciate this. And, you know, deep down inside, all of us are beginning to understand the beauty of this Samarpan, you know, we surrender to Dada in the day of the Gnanvidhi, but our surrender intensity continues more and more day by day, not only to Dada, but to Mahatmas of Dada Shri, you see, Mahatmas, all the Mahatmas here in this satsang, you see, to anyone, any Mahatma that you come across, you see. In the first, you know, Dada teaches us these are very special people. I want you to know these are extremely special, you know, that's in our Charanvedi, you know, that these are no ordinary human beings. They are human beings who are totally separated from their activities, their kriya, you see. They are all going to go to moksha in a one or two lifetimes. Their state cannot be matched with anything. So yes, my dear Sandra and all of you, yes, this is how we look at it, you see. You know, there is in with that approach, there is nothing except the wonder of Dada, you know, the magnificent wonder of Dada.
Dice Shudas, Sandra, que es tanto el amor que tenemos por Dada que cada persona que puede traernos un conocimiento nos acerque a él, le tenemos este agradecimiento y este amor. Y que bueno, Dada dice que somos que estos Mahatmas son personas tan especiales y que van a alcanzar Moksha en dos o tres vidas. Y esta es la dedicación, ¿no? Lo que decidimos rendirnos, como nos rendimos a los pies de Dada en el Nandvidhi, continuamos haciéndolo cada vez más profundamente.
Yeah.
Y que, bueno, agradece mucho esto.
Yeah. When one sentence of Dada, only one sentence of Dada is offered to another human being, as it is, unmanipulated, untouched by any ego or kashas, it produces magnificent results. I mean, you know, the person who receives it is blessed, and the person who is sharing it is blessed. So it is just a blessing process multiplied by blessing multiplied by blessing, you see.
Dicen que cuando la palabra de Dada es compartida exactamente como es, sin haber sido cambiada, tocada o manipulada, cuando son las exactas palabras de Dada, estas palabras que recibe la persona, es como las bendice, y también bendice al que las da. Entonces es una bendición, otra bendición y otra bendición.
Yeah, when the two of you sang the three mantras, you were just the knowers. You were seeing how it was being sung. You were the seers, you were seeing. And you also knew how it was being sung, you see.
Dice que cuando cantan el Trimantra, ustedes pueden ver y también conocer qué es lo que está sucediendo.
And when this comes to a level of perfection, when it comes to the level of perfection, and then the Sahajatma, the natural soul, is there with all its energies for you, all its energies, you know, it just flows. Whatever is there in Carlos or Sandra, in terms of the offering, this offering of this flower of the three mantra, is untouched. It is that, you know, and the beauty is that it is an eternal flower, you know, it is a flower that never wilts, it never becomes old, you see, that it just carries on, passes on from one generation to the other, to the other, to the other, just generation after generations, you see.
Esto es como cuando cantan el Trimantra. En ese momento ustedes están viendo y todas las divinas energías que vienen, es como se abre una flor que se ofrece y es una flor que no se marchita y que continúa generaciones por generaciones.
So in all of this, that songs of Dada, our prayer is essentially, oh Dada, these words represent everything for me. You see, every other word except your words, every other view except your view, is I have no use for it. I already, it goes in the other direction. Only your view, my Lord, Dada, Bhagwan, only your view is who I am. I want this only. I want to continue to be in the exactness of the line that you're leading me into, you see, this seeing and knowing, the seeing and knowing. I mean, we know, you and I are discussing these things. It is unbelievable. Except for Mahatmas and the Gnani of Akram Vignan, this is not available for human beings of this world of ours, you see. This exactness of seeing, you see.
Estas palabras de Dada, ¿no? Y la visión de Dada es solo tener la visión de Dada. Y esto de sus palabras y su visión es quien realmente soy. Y es la exacta línea que nos conduce a Dada. El ver y el conocer. Y esto sin que es para los Mahatmas y para el Nani. Y para el resto es como... no son creíbles para el resto de las personas, solo para los Mahatmas y el Nani.
This is, there was one sentence that I did not translate for you in this first paragraph that we shared today, when the other says, you may feel as if I am, but I am doing all of these things, right? But I am not the doer of any of the activities of Ambalal Patel. So if I'm not the doer of any of the activities of A.M. Patel, then what am I? Then I am the overseer. I am the Gnata Trashta of all of that. I not only am, because to be is one thing and to continue to be is subtle. You see, the subtle difference between to be and to continue to be that, you see.
Hay una frase que quiere compartir y es que Dada dice, yo no soy el hacedor de las actividades de M. Patel, yo soy Gnata Drashta, yo soy el observador y conocedor. Entonces dice es ser el observador y el conocedor y continúo siendo el observador y el conocedor, ¿no? Como hace una distinción entre ser y continuamente ser, el conocedor y observador.
So, you know, I was, you know, the way it has evolved in Gujarati, the way it has evolved in Sanskrit and in all the Indian languages, Hindi, etc., It is written as Gnata Drashta, knower dash seer, knower seer, knower seer, knower dash seer, knower seer, you see. Why not seer knower? You see, I mean, generally you have, you know, why is knower seer? Because the knower has arisen. You know that knower, to know something means to experience it, you see. So to know, knower has arisen. I know that I am not Sandra or Cecilia or Gavi. I now know that I am not Anila, you see. I am not Anila. I also know what Anila is. The knowing part is the experience of the self, you see. I know. And then that knowing, that knowledge is associated automatically with seeing with the eyes of the self. Shuddha drashti, this divya chakshu, the divine vision. Yes, the divine vision.
Yes. En India, ¿no? En Gujarati, en cualquier lugar, se llama al conocedor y el observador Gnata Drashta. Gnata es el conocedor, Drashta es el observador. ¿Por qué el conocedor tiene esta razón? Es por la experiencia. Esa es la razón por la cual sabe que no es Cecilia, que no es Sandra, que no es Anila. Y también sabe quién es Anila y qué es lo que Anila hace. Y este es el conocimiento para ver con el ojo del ser para tener la visión divina.
And for us in Akram, the seeing is given a lot of importance because the knower, look, the knower, you and I as the knower, you know, has arisen and is eternal. You and I are the knowers. Now, where we miss out, where we are not, where we are deficient, is in the seeing process. We do not see. And what are we supposed to see? We discussed that in the entire satsang last week, to see only one Pudgal, right? See what Patricia is doing, what is happening to Patricia, what is happening to the mind, how the mind is being affected, how the chit is being drawn in different directions, how the intellect is giving opinions, or how the ego is taking on the load of stupid niabla suffering. So you can see, to see that, you see?
Para nosotros, a ver. Para nosotros este camino de Akram, el ser, desde el Akram, el conocedor somos el conocedor, ¿no? Y en el proceso de y ver es el proceso de ver el Pudgal, ver para dónde va la mente, para dónde va el chit, dónde está, qué opiniones tiene el intelecto, a dónde va el cuerpo, es ver el Pudgal.
Ese I know you probably get tired because I give you so many Gujarati words, but you know those Gujarati words are very unique with a very special meaning. To describe that one word will take a whole paragraph, right? Yeah, and I'm sure such words exist in your own language too, you know, which you use. For instance, there is this word called daphodia, 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 you see. Daphodia means you see everything except what's going on inside you. You know, what did she say? What did he do? Did he do this or not? Oh, the boy did that? All right, you know. So you're continuously just externalized vision. Oh, whoa, 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 you know. Whoa. You see that? You see that? That's called, you know, you're taking a stick and stirring it up. You know, you got this beautiful silent internal pond, lake. You see, lake. You're taking that stick and stirring it up. You see, you're stirring it up. You know, the water. So you stir up the water, and you cannot see anything inside. You know, you cannot see. When the water is silent and clear, you can see all the way to the bottom where you can see the rocks, etc., the fish, you see?
Yes. Nos da una palabra que es daphodia, que quiere decir que tenemos una visión externa. Vemos afuera y no vemos lo que sucede dentro, ¿no? Entonces es estamos viendo ver qué es lo que sucede afuera todo el tiempo. Y por ejemplo, si nos acercamos a un lago que está pacífico, podemos ver el fondo, podemos ver los peces, podemos ver todo. Pero si con un palo vamos y sacudimos el agua, entonces no podemos ver, ¿no? Y estamos molestando esa hermosa paz que tenía el lago.
You see, to stir up, not only you stir up, but you stir up with the stick of opinions. You see, is a stick is not a physical stick, but you see, you take that opinions, you know, opinions, rag, dvish, that opinions generate rag, dvish, you see, because other people do not, they will not generate rag, dvish in you and I, attachment, aversion, because, you know, but in others, it will generate attachment, aversion.
Él cuando dices que pones el cuando dice Yuda que poner el palo en el agua y sacudirlo, entonces no vemos la profundidad, es el palo de las opiniones. Las opiniones son las que nos llevan a Ragdwish, ¿no? Que es el apego y la aversión.
So, you know, going back to last week's satsang, because this is in continuation, this is the beauty of the way with which Niruma sees this liberation of Akram Vignan Mahatmas. She captured everything from Dada sitting by his side, you know, taking care of his food part and all his, you know, washing part, his clothes, everything that was necessary for him. And then also making sure she doesn't miss a single sentence while he is doing satsang. Also cooking, you know, for him, you see. And also being the editor of this magazine that we are reading from, you know, Akram Vignan magazine, you see, I mean, all of this, managing his flights, managing the money part, where are we going to go, where we were, yeah, one person, you know, only one person. She didn't have, you know, hundreds of people that are available for Puja Shri, you see, she only solo, Niruma, you know, and there it is. You see, she is now giving us, she has brought us to the, almost to the top of the mountain, you know, where we can see clearly. There are no bushes, there are no tall trees, nothing. We can see, wherever we look, we see, you see, and we see with clarity. And that is what she wants us to also. And that is how she wants. She says, this is the way. There is no other way. This is the way. This is the way.
Yes. Niruma, Niruma cuidaba a Dada, lo cuidaba, lo bañaba, le cocinaba, también, y no se perdía, y mientras que hacía toda la actividad de cuidarlo, no se perdía una sola palabra de Dada. Y también editó todo esto, editó esta revista de Akram y guardó cada palabra de Dada. También manejaba el dinero, organizaba los viajes, y no estaba disponible mucha gente para apoyarla con esto, ¿no? Pero ella hizo todo esto y nos lleva a la punta del tope de la montaña para que podamos ver sin obstáculos, sin árboles que no nos permitan ver. Ella quería que nosotros pudiéramos ver con absoluta claridad. Este es la visión que ella nos quería dejar.
Now, a very phenomenal sentence that Dada gave in the last satsang to us, which is, this is, there are, you know, when she was talking about what was the Lord doing, seeing only one Pudgal, seeing the one Pudgal. Dada, in his beauty, he is not saying, look, I'm there. First, he describes the state of Lord Mahavir, the fully enlightened one, and then he goes to himself. He said, there are only two. There is the fully enlightened one, and then there is Gnani Purush Dada Shri. You see, so in the last week he said, and I just shared the sentence with you, that, you know, instead of doing Daffodia, the stick, you see, the stick of opinions that disturb other human beings, you see. Instead of messing around outside, there are continuous results happening inside. Results happening inside. That they are so subtle. There is subtle results happening inside. These subtle results are so subtle that the world outside, the non-Akram Vignan world, the non-awakened world, is not qualified even to see it. Not qualified. They are not certified. They have not arrived there yet. They cannot see. And the awakened ones of Akram Vignan, you and I, Mahatmas, remain. That's where we remain, the knower and the seer. Dada is elevating us, saying, see, Mahatmas can see that. Mahatmas can see what can begin to see what Lord Mahavir, the Tirthankar of this world, was doing, seeing. And Gnani Purush Dadashi, seeing. And you and I now see, you see? You continue to see.
Yes. Dada primero describe el estado del ser, ¿no? Y después este frente a Lord Mahavir, ¿no? Y después el ser totalmente iluminado por él y el Nani Purush también ven. Este, y en lugar de estar agitando afuera o molestando, este, él solo miraba qué era lo que sucedía en él y cuáles eran los resultados sutiles que sucedían dentro de él. Y en el mundo nadie está calificado para ver o capacitado para poder ver esto. Solo los Mahatmas de Dada pueden permanecer en el estado y como Lord Mahavir. Lord Mahavir ve, Dada ve y nosotros también. Ahora podemos ver.
You see, the Lord, we have his murtis, we have the visible shape of where him sitting, you know, like the Tirthankar, he's sitting, you see, in a temple, you know. And we say Namo Siddharnam, because he is gone out of this universe. He is Siddha Namo Siddharnam. And then we see Lord Simandar again in a murti. And we say Namo Arihantarnam. But now we need to know. Now we need to know. He's not doing anything. We need to know, you know, why this shape sitting there, you see. You know, because for centuries and centuries, you know, and hundreds of thousands of years, they knew the final fact that this world is operating. This world that is in front of them is on autopilot, you see. Yeah, the hands are moving, the mind is thinking, the words are coming out, the bodies are doing the activities, the kriyas, you see. So, when we see the murtis of the Lord, or when we see the murti of our photograph of I am Patel, like we have in Cecilia's picture here, when we see him, we know now in exactness that he is seeing what I am Patel is doing. And he's not seeing anything else. You see, he does not see anything else except that he, M. Patel, answers, you know, as the Gnani, he will answer, listen to the questions and answer the questions. But he continues to see what the Gnani is speaking and whether the answers are correct or not. You see, he just continues to see that. And he shares this exact beauty of this three levels with all of us. Now the Bhagwan, the Gnata Drashta, the knower, seer, absolute, Gnani Purush, speaking to Mahatmas or new seekers in the satsang. And Aram Patel going to buy vegetables for Hiraba, his wife, or doing whatever business he has to do with the world, you know. All three, these two, he has come, he's in continuous bliss. He is in continuous bliss. He is in moksha. He is in moksha, you see.
Yes. Podemos estar viendo a los murtis que están, el Lord y los murtis que están sentados en un templo, ¿no? Y los vemos ahí y decimos Namo Sitanam, porque ellos están fuera de este mundo. Cuando vemos el murti de Simandar, decimos Namo Arihantanam, porque él está acá, ¿no? Y. Pero no, es como solo observa y conoce y nada que hacer. Y nosotros por siglos y por miles de siglos, éramos los últimos, ¿no? Del conocimiento de que este mundo, no teníamos el conocimiento de que este mundo funciona a través de piloto automático, que toda la mente, el cuerpo y el habla están programados. Entonces podemos ver los murtis, podemos ver las fotos, y sabemos en exactitud qué es lo que estamos viendo, qué es lo que vemos. Vemos en Patel y no ve otra cosa, ¿no? Está el Nani que escucha preguntas y da respuestas y ve, observa si están bien las respuestas o no están bien. Y comparte con nosotros todos estos niveles del ser absoluto de Jnata Drashta. Y también lo ve a M. Patel, que va de compras a la verdulería para comprar los vegetales para su esposa. Pero siempre está en un continuo estado de dicha. Y eso es moksha.
You know, Moni, dear, do you understand what? Do you have any questions, Monica?
¿Alguna pregunta, Monica?
Want to say something?
¿Quieres decir algo?
So you see, what you're aware that Monica does not have any questions. Monica is smiling. Monica is liking and loving these words of Dada. That's enough.
Puedes ver Mónica, la Mónica, que no tiene preguntas, que está sonriendo y que está disfrutando de estas palabras de Dada.
Day by day, he's moving you and I away from this is happening to me. I did something wrong, I did something right. Doing something wrong or right is not in our hands at all. It is not part of us. Monica will do something right, Monica will do something wrong, you see? You understand?
Cada día nos movemos, nos vamos más lejos de esto. Esto me sucede a mí, o hacer algo bien o mal, o a Mónica. Mónica hace algo bien o hace algo mal, eso no es no es así, no eres la hacedora.
And when you are fixed in that understanding, then no niabla can create any kind of confusion for you, you see. It's the niablas will come and go, you see.
Entonces cuando tú te aferras y tienes tienes este entendimiento, ya no hay niebla que pueda obstaculizarte. Va y viene.
So just kind of, you know, you and I have climbed little hills or little mountains, you see. We have gone on the trail, the path where, you know, it's just a trail in the jungle, you know, in the forest, and then slowly the forest clears, and now there is only small shrubs and bushes, you see. And you go higher and higher, and then only there are rocks, you see. And you go higher and higher, and then, you know, the higher you go, it becomes more and more beautiful. The air is clear. See, yeah. All sense of being bound or is gone, you know. Yes.
Dice, todos tenemos montañas, tenemos montes, y en esto de ir escalándolos, subiéndolos, vamos a encontrar bosques, seguimos escalando y encontramos arbustos, y seguimos y ya hay rocas, hasta que llegamos al pico de la montaña o el monte que estamos escalando, y cada vez vemos más y más hermoso, con más belleza, y podemos sentir que el aire cada vez es más puro, y también la liberación de las ataduras.
So, you know, Sridhar Bhagwan, I just realized we have finished our time for the day, but, you know, we will continue on this. This is like this, you know, when you are in that space where the mount, you know, you wonder, well, why do people hike and go, you know, go climb up hills and go higher? You know, and because they feel free when they see around, they say, what beauty, what so much beauty. The world below, down below is forgotten. There is no, the world doesn't bother you.
Yes. Dice, la gente quiere trepar las montañas, ir a escalar y ir ahí, porque son momentos donde el mundo se encuentran tanta belleza y tanta paz.
And so this is the Akram Vignan virtual hike. You see, every time we are in the satsang of Dada, with Dada, he just says, he will say, come Patricia, come Moni, come, let's go for a walk and let's go for a hike. You see, come with me. Oh, I don't like to walk. There are, you know, all kinds of animals. He says, no. This is the beauty, inner hike with Dada.
Yes.
He takes you off.
Este es el Akram Vignan, ¿no? Virtual, ¿no? De ir escalando la montaña. Vamos a escalar. Por ahí no quieren, pero ven igual.
Yes. So should that, my Bhagwan. Yes, namaskar. Thank you so much for our dear Gabi for doing all of this translations, and our dear Patricia and all of this. Jai Sachidanand, until we meet again.
Jai Sachidanand, and thank you for living what Sudha was doing and come with us. Thank you.
Well, you know, this evening there is a Gnanvidhi, so Sudha will sit in the Gnanvidhi again with everyone. You know, and there's going to be a lot of people here in Tampa. We are in Tampa, Florida. And so we'll be with the Gnani, but you know, so again, you know, you can also join in the Gnanvidhi through your energies, you see. You know, and this is your Gnan day, so you do Dada Bhagwana Simje Jekar Ho, and then, you know, just see how you have come up this mountain, you know, just how you have come up this beautiful space, you see. You see it.
Hoy es día de Gnanvidhi en Tampa, en Florida. Así que a la tarde podemos unirnos desde nuestra alma pura y rezar o cantar Dada Bhagwana Simje Jekar Ho, ya que es el cumpleaños de muchos de nosotros que recibimos el Gnanvidhi.
Yes, and I will share with you. I will find, you know, share with you this July Dadavani, which is on Dada Bhagwan Nasim Ji Ji Karho, okay? Yeah, there is, okay?
Yes, va a estar dándonos el Dadavani donde habla del Dada Bhagwan Nasim Ji Ji Karho.
Yes, Devadasi, Jay Sachidanan, Gonzalo, Octavia, everyone.
Jay Sachidanan, Sua, gracias.
Jay Sachidanan, eh? Yes, Jay Sachidanan, Rosie, everyone. Yeah, yeah. And,